Over 2,000 years ago, as China was first united by Emperor Qin Shi Huang, a vast trading network was controlled by a widowed merchant woman. The grand historian Sima Qian said that the emperor respected her for her chastity. But there must have been something else to their relationship, something that held the emperor and the widow in a common bond. Cinnabar, mercury sulfide. Prized in medicines, religious practice, and for its pigment, vermilion. This was the substance the widow Ba Qing dealt him. Fabrics dyed with the pigment and placed in tombs have been unearthed with colors as bright as they were when buried 2,000 years ago. In fact, cinnabar played an important role in many funerary practices. Its traces have been found scattered in tombs going back over 3,000 years.
That重庆现在的话发现的 就是有明显的单杀痕迹的，就是10年的时候我们在涪陵。 发现过一座墓葬，它的等级还比较高，是属于那个西汉时期的。它的墓葬里面有很多单杀，我们当时就采集了一些样品，可能都有那个1000克多。然后当地有一些民风民俗，可能作为啊这个单杀可能是一种财富或者一种宗教上面的象征，然后把它随葬到那个墓葬里面。当时巴钦家族他掌握了那种。 就是比较先进的那个提炼手段的话，和开它首先是它有地理条件，它占据了那个蕴藏量特别丰富的矿山。其次，它又掌握了比较先进的那个提炼技术的话，它当时属于全国垄断的地位的话，当时那个单砂又是属于一种那种就是大家比较认同的，然后因为单砂的作用很多，它可以入药，可以那个做装饰、做颜料，然后它可以提炼水银。
In ancient Chinese belief, cinnabar was analogous to blood, which gave it the power to drive away evil spirits. Its ability to be magically transformed from blood red earth to the silvery liquid mercury gave it further symbolic
power。人活着的时候，血是鲜红的；人死了过后，血就变黑了。好，单砂矿是红颜色的，所以把这个，把单砂矿啊，把那个单砂呢，用来放到死者的身边。 他有希望死者起死回生，有这么一个追求在里边。另外呢，后来人们通过观察呢，就发现，单杀呢还有一个作用，它能够让尸体不腐烂。好，古代的中国人呢有这么一种意识，认为人的肉体跟灵魂是两码事。好，人死了过后是灵魂。 暂时的离开了这个肉体，如果能够保住这个肉体不腐烂，灵魂还可以回来，还可以起死回生。Both
mercury and cinnabar have strong antibacterial and disinfectant qualities. They are both also highly toxic to humans. But without this scientific knowledge, the ancient Chinese believed that cinnabar could be the secret to eternal life. Emperor Qin Shi Huang's mausoleum was built at the foot of Li Mountain at Lintong in Xi'an. In the early 1980s, researchers surveying the site found that the mercury levels in the soil of the tomb mound were up to 100 times higher than normal. This would seem to support Sima Qian's description of the tomb as containing a model of the emperor's domains with the rivers made from mercury.
This water is not from the earth itself, but from a kind of sifu拱. This means that this water拱 is from the earth. From the earth, the water is released.随着土壤的缝隙，然后来上升传到这个封土里边的。
Mercury, a liquid metal at normal temperatures, it's volatile and vaporizes easily. This has always made it a health hazard to those who work with the liquid. 38 years building his great underground necropolis.After finally uniting his empire, he was able to devote even more resources to the tomb's construction. It's estimated he used around 100 tons of mercury.
After the Qing Song built the temple, he had to give the temple a gift. This is a gift, or is a gift to the temple.他得到个消息过后，就毅然地提供了大量的白银，他的资产啊不可计数，大量的白银。后来秦始皇要修建他的秦陵墓，又需要水银，又提供了大量的水银。
In the historical records, Sima Qian lists many early generations of successful merchants.But Ba Qing was the only one who made her wealth through cinnabar mining and smelting mercury. She would be obvious for key resources for the project so close to the emperor's heart, and indeed for one even closer.The emperor didn't just need mercury for his mausoleum. He needed cinnabar and those with the knowledge of its secrets to achieve his highest goal, physical immortality. Like many wealthy cult followers of his time, and for 1,000 years thereafter, the emperor ate cinnabar potions in the hope of escaping or at least postponing death. Cinnabar, a remedy for all diseases of internal organs, nurtures the spirit, calms the soul,and kills all demons and evils. Its long-term usage will result in immortality and the ability to connect with gods. So reads the oldest Chinese pharmacological compendium from the 2nd century. The ancient Chinese discovered that when cinnabar is heated in the current of air, the condensed vapor yields mercury, and when mercury is heated with cinnabar, it returns to its original form.The seemingly magical cycle made it appear like cinnabar held the key to understanding life, the universe, and everything. Tao Hong Jing, a Taoist scholar and alchemist, wrote in the 5th century, "Cinnabar is the essence to all psychic concoctions, a treasure to make men immortal."
Ban Shan, it is in China, it is a very important.养生的药品，在历史上我们说丹砂就是不死之药。中国历代很多皇帝啊，他们倾其所有，到处寻找什么？寻找不死之药。
The emperor was afraid of death, and even forbade the use of the word in his presence.His consumption of cinnabar would have resulted in a slow poisoning, accompanied by hallucinations and violent mood swings. Having spent so long fighting to unite his empire,The emperor was now desperate to spend the longest time he could ruling over it. But his health began to deteriorate, and the consumption of cinnabar would have been a major cause. One of his generals described him as a man with a high-bridged nose, long narrow eyes, a pigeon chest, and the voice of a jackal.
He has a big red eye, a long, narrow eye, a pigeon chest, and the voice of a jackal. 从这几个体态特征来看，秦始皇虽然贵为始皇帝，但是他的身体条件不大好。
Poor health made the emperor even more desperate for the fabled elixir. The secret of immortality was often believed to reside with ancient mountain hermits. One scholar suggested the emperor himself live as a recluse in order to find it. The emperor was far from being alone in believing such a thing was possible. To pander to his concerns, some told the emperor about the mythical islands in the Eastern Ocean where immortal herbs could be found. In 219 BC, the emperor sent his envoy, Shu Fu, on a voyage with 1,000 virgin boys and girls in search of the magical herb. They never returned. To have returned unsuccessful would undoubtedly be a sentence of death. By legend, they settled in Japan. The closest the emperor now could be sure he could get to the secret was someone who knew all about cinnabar.
因为八卦符，啊，拆杀连狂，啊，这个狂来讲呢，它的，啊，连的结果就是水银，啊，水银，水银呢，经过一定的冶炼提炼，就会炼成一种叫做丹药。丹药，这个丹药可以治病，可以防腐，啊，这就为以后啊秦代啊秦始皇的追随长生不老之仙丹丹药提供了物质条件和冶炼技术，啊，冶炼技术。因此，秦始皇到处寻丹长生不老之药，与八卦符有直接关系。
Drug taking to try to extend life seems to have been a common practice from the earliest days of the empire. The symptoms of heavy metal poisoning, hallucinations, and feelings of bodily lightness were, for some, a proof that the elixir was working. The book composed for a prince in 120 BC describes a recipe of pills made from mercury, cinnabar, and realgar. It's not known whether the prince would have actually tried them himself.
丹砂呢，作为一种中药呢，《李时珍的本草纲目》里边有记载，主要的说它能够治五脏的白病，能够养精神，能够能够安神，安神安魂。还有能够杀毒，他说的很多，但是这个东西呢，它是有毒的。虽然这个，李时珍的《本草纲目》说它没有毒，但是它是有毒的。如果这个超过了一定的量，它就会有副作用。中国历史上，因为服食丹药发生的悲剧很多很多，大概就是超越了那个量。
From the 7th to the 10th centuries, a series of Tang Dynasty emperors succumbed to the effect of toxic elixirs. Eventually, the attempt to attain immortality this way was recognized as futile, But not before it had killed thousands of wealthy elite over hundreds of years. Even today, cinnabar is regarded as of unique importance in Chinese medicine, and many popular remedies use it, or claim to use it, as an ingredient, at least in minute quantities. In Emperor Qin Shi Huang's time, with no knowledge of its dangers, its consumption was widespread among those wealthy enough to afford it. There can have been few substances the first emperor valued more highly or was more inclined to hoard. However, there may have been something else behind the emperor's relationship with Ba Qian. Sima Qian, in his historical records, described her as being a chaste woman. But the title at that time could have another meaning.
所以那个曾字的本来含义，第一层，曾者正也，就是一个正大的、不可侵犯的这么样一个女性，这算一个解释。第二，这个曾啊，你看这个字的本来的含义，它上面是一个占卜的卜，下面是一个宝贝的贝。其实这个字《说文》里头讲得很清楚，是吧？曾者，仆问也，就是占卜。 问吉凶，好了，真仆问也，这是谁？什么样的人才能做这样的工作呢
？In the Shang and Zhou dynasties, a chaste man usually referred to a mage or fortune teller who could communicate with the gods, divining answers to questions and also treatments for the sick. The careful choice of words used by Sima Qian could well imply the same thing. Not only was Ba Qing the source of the cinnabar and mercury that the emperor needed, she also acted as a personal oracle or even alchemist to the emperor. She was responsible for concocting the vital elixir itself.
北方叫真人，南方就叫巫，真者巫也，所以说。 这个真字透露出一个信息，八卦夫妻，有可能是巫，也就是说，他有可能是医生。In
ancient China, diviners were responsible for many different areas of life. They not only led religious ceremonies and practiced their divination to determine the best course for future actions. They also predicted illness and possible treatments, as well as serving as teachers and mentors.
People in nature, because the production is relatively low, they feel a kind of helpless, unable to do anything. So they need this strong desire,
In ancient times, oracles, sorcerers, and doctors often overlap. In the traditional Chinese, the character for doctor is based on that for sorcerer.
他是不是巫，我们搞不清楚。我们刚才说的巫医同源，但是没有说他是医生。但他那个在既然在那个在开扯单杀、提炼单杀呢，可有可能如果推测的话，有可能他懂。啊，但从这个角度来看，也可以说他懂跟那个巫也要沾边的。
In fact, local folklore describes Qing's husband's ancestor, who found the cinnabar mine, as being a doctor or herbalist. The cinnabar mines were mostly found in the southeast Sichuan area, where the culture of the magicians originated and thrived. To nearby Mount Wu, meaning Sorcerer's Mountain in Chinese, was also known as the Spirit Mountain. This region of the Three Gorges was Ba Qing's homeland.
So, 八卦夫妻实际上它是一个巫，巫就是一个什么带有神话的那种人，她往往被人神化，就说她是一个有神性的女性，所以她的地位就非同寻常。
This could explain how a widow from a remote county was able to gain such favor from the emperor himself. The semi-divine status of a priestess might grant her the power to live beyond the laws applied to others.
Because in the ancient times, when people have sickness and death, first of all, they need to seek a method. 然后至于他的这种疾患，那么在这个时候呢，因为巫师呢，他是最高级的知识分子，他可能呢掌握了一些这种草药的这种技术，对一些植物的这种药性呢，他会比平常人呢，他多一些认识，所以呢，他也会利用这种丹砂，利用一些民间的草药，然后呢给这些老百姓治病。那么他的这种效力呢，总比肯定会给你等死这种，听天由命要强，所以呢，他在人们心目中呢，他能就拥会拥有一定的地位。So
the emperor would have relied on Ba Qing for her supplies of cinnabar and her knowledge of how to use it to make his so desperately desired elixir of immortality. And when that elixir began to damage his health, he would probably have looked to her for a cure too. But the political and military importance of the Ba region could not be ignored either. Trouble down there could lead to serious problems for the emperor.
他为什么要扶持？一个从战略上考虑，这个大家族是我打楚国的重要的依靠力量，就是他经营的丹砂。 跟人类的健康长寿有关系，跟秦国的统一大业有关系，所以综合起来，秦国的历朝君王会重视巴渝地区那些豪强大族。反过来，豪强大族也要需要这样一种政治力量，来给他支持，作为他的靠山。So
the woman described by Sima Qian as a chaste merchant's widow controlled a commercial empire. Quite possibly a significant-sized army, and served as personal priestess to Physic the emperor himself. As the grand historian wrote, she was indeed the equal of any monarch. If the widow Ba Qing was truly the sorceress who had the power to make the elixir of immortality and communicate with the gods, what role did she play in Emperor Qin Shi Huang's wars with his rivals? Please join us for part 4 of The Mystery of the Cinnabar Queen.